Welcome to the hottest movie review on the internet today, the A-List Review. I am your host, the Game Changer, Wes Troop. And today I'm here to review a movie that came out, just a few days ago, and I got the chance to check it out. And this is a movie that's been getting some very mixed reviews. So we will see where I clock in. Ladies and gentlemen, my review of the 2017 fantasy action film, King Arthur, Legend of the Sword, coming up now. Uther Pendragon, King of the Britons, is betrayed when his own brother, Vortigern, orchestrates a coup which ends up seeing Uther and his wife killed by a demon knight, and Vortigern takes the crown for himself. Uther's young son survives, though, and drifts away on a boat, ending up in Londinium, where he is raised by prostitutes in a brothel and given the name Arthur. Arthur grows up to be a skilled street fighter and hears of a magical sword that appeared in a stone near Vortigern's castle. Arthur succeeds in pulling out the sword and soon discovers his true lineage. After Vortigern's attempted execution of Arthur fails, Arthur gains the willpower to control the sword, Excalibur, and plans to retake the throne, which is rightfully his. So what did I think of King Arthur, Legend of the Sword? I thought it's a ghastly fantasy action film. After hearing of the project and seeing the trailer, my anticipation level for this film was zero. Sometimes I'll be pleasantly surprised by a film that I'm not necessarily looking forward to seeing, but I certainly can't say that in this case. From the first battle scene, complete with humongous elephants swinging boulders, we can tell this is going to be a strange journey. While I had many problems with the film, I felt the biggest was its horrendous breakneck speed editing. The action sequences could have been fine, but they go by so fast it's hard to tell what's happening. There's a chase scene that even made me laugh unintentionally because of how it was filmed. Along the way, Arthur battles a number of monsters, including giant bats and rats, and a final villain that looks like he stepped out of a PlayStation 1 game. A gigantic snake also shows up in the finale. The second half of the film is very CGI heavy, and the effects look lame. There's also a number of fast-paced montages, one of which we see Arthur's childhood go by in about 30 seconds. The film also has the habit of telling stories through flashbacks, showing what happened while the character tells the story using quick jump cuts, and this effect is used way too often and sometimes makes the story a bit hard to follow. I felt like it tried to pack too many stories into the script, resulting in certain story elements getting too much or too little screen time. I also felt many of the characters were dull, and the female roles, the few that there are very uninspired. The film clocks in at just over 2 hours, but was such a chore for me to sit through, it felt like I was watching it for 10 hours. The performances range everywhere from okay, hammy, to dreadful, starring Charlie Hunnam as Arthur Pendragon, the rightful king ready to face his uncle and take back his throne, Astrid Burgess Frisbee as the mage, an acolyte of Merlin who helps Arthur on his mission, Jimon Hounsou as Sir Bevedere, King Uther's former general Arthur teams up with, Aidan Gillen as Goosefat Bill, another one of Arthur's new comrades, Jude Law as Vortigern, Arthur's uncle who sacrificed his family members in order to become king, and Eric Bana as Uther, Arthur's father and the King of Britain. While it tries to tell the legendary stories in a new epic way, King Arthur, Legend of the Sword was a big-time misfire, and I think I'd rather have a root canal than a repeat viewing. So King Arthur, Lore, Legend of the Sword, you know what rating you get? I got two words for you. Suck it. All right, well, that's the show. I'll be back with another review very soon. I will be checking out Alien Covenant this weekend, as well as I'll be doing a review of Snatched. So make sure you tune back in for those. But until then, don't forget to subscribe right here on YouTube. YouTube.com/westsideof515. You can like the show on Facebook, facebook.com/WesTrueBaylist. And of course, you can follow me on the Twitter, @WesAlist, and the Instagram, @WesAlist. Until next time, Troop out.